lost in the rabbit hole. Connect every emotion, experience, adventure, struggle, pain, and achievement. Know the past, feel the future, and live this moment with Nisha Harale. Every Sunday on Niche Radio.
Hello everyone, and thank you for tuning in to our first episode of Let's Get Lost in the Rabbit Hole. On Niche Radio with me, Nisha Harale. Joining me today is someone I personally look up to as an artist. He has internationally made his mark and has captured many hearts on the dance floor. Yes, right now, in conversation with me is the super talented psychedelic artist, Spinal Fusion. Hi Bilas, aka Spinal Fusion. Are you all set to get lost in the rabbit hole?
Yes, I'm ready.
Let's get to the start of your journey from Bilas to Spinal Fusion. And why the name Spinal Fusion?
Basically, the name is Spinal Fusion because in the year 2008, when I met with a car accident in Calcutta, where I was residing first. So after the car accident, I shifted to Delhi for a rehabilitation process because it was a spinal cord injury and it had to be treated in a very different way. I was not in this music scene, basically. So I was more into sports. I was playing cricket for my state at that time. So once I went to Delhi and I was there for in rehabilitation center. I was with my laptop and small speaker, so small stereo system inside the rehab, where I was having my own one room. And I started listening to this this genre, electronic music. And inside electronic music, I started listening to trance music. And then it slowly, harder BPM stuff, then it was psychedelic trance. And then where it actually was the point, you know, like I started downloading a software, basically a DAW, and I started producing, you know, small loops and samples. Then I started, exploring more about this particular genre called psychedelic trance, psytrance music. Yeah, so once I finished my rehabilitation process, by the time 2009, I came back to Mumbai. It gradually kept on moving, you know, and then in the year 2008, I first released my EP. I think it was in Digital Distortion Records from Mumbai. And that's basically been the journey from Bilas to Spinal Fusion, which came into my head. And I thought, yeah, let's start with this project because this is very, very, very much connected with my name and the injury that I have it. So, yeah, this is where the name has come from, Spinal Fusion.
This is truly inspiring, and there's so much to learn from you. You said that you wanted to be a cricketer. Did you always wanted to be a cricketer?
It was like I started at the age of 8, you know, like starting to go to the coaching camps, basically, of the cricket coaching camps. So I started at the age of 8. So yeah, I started from that age, and I've played for my states. I've played under 15 until under 19. I've played. I've been to the NCAA camps also, National Cricket Academy, Bangalore.
You converted your pain into creativity. That is truly inspiring. I want to know, how did the journey continue? Was there a moment in your life where you thought you wanted to give up?
When this accident happened, and because I was into sports and I was representing my state, and I had to represent my nationals in under 15 also cricket. So when the accident happened, and it was just a career changing point of your life, basically. You know, like you have to start everything from zero. When I had come to know about this, like I have a spinal cord injury, because I had no idea what was a spinal cord injury. I had it after the accident. And yeah, this process was, it was basically a process, you know, like I never looked back. Okay, so yeah, I'm not into sports, so like what's gonna happen? So I never look it back, you know, like I took the positivity out of it, you know, like what more can I do with this? Whatever has happened now I have to move forward with this. So yeah, I started producing music. Before producing music, yeah, I was producing music at in the year 2010 where I started, but I was just producing, you know, like I was not knowing what to do and where to do. So then there was a point I came up something to my head that I want to do sound engineering. So I had done my sound engineering and recording from Mumbai itself, from Digital Academy. My tutor was Mr. Daman Sood. So there where I learned about sound engineering and recording, yeah, that process has helped me a lot, like from change to, you know, like that, from what I was doing from an amateur to a professional, like, you know. So that thing has helped me a lot. And so yeah, there are points, you know, like when I was never into DJing. So I started producing my own music, you know. So it takes a lot of time to basically, if you're doing your own music, how you gonna play? That's the main thing. So there was no gigs at the very start. So the first gig where I played basically was in Goa. Basically, it was in Hilltop, where I came in connection with Starling, the guy from Hilltop itself, the owner from Hilltop. So he said, yeah, we like your music and you're invited to come down and play for us. So I was, yeah, pretty excited. And then, yeah, that time in 2010, 2011, that journey began of proper Spinal Fusion production and the gig journey.
From your first gig at Hilltop to Boom Festival, how did that happen?
So yeah, basically it was the year 2010-11 when I started sending messages to organizers on the fan pages, basically, of their official pages. And all of a sudden I get a message from the Hilltop owner, you know, like, yeah, we like your music and we would like to invite you to play at the Hilltop Christmas party. I was excited, yeah. I was like very excited because that's going to be my first gig, basically, one of the biggest platforms to feature my project. Once I finished that gig, then I made a lot of tracks in that span of 2011, 2014, you know. And my first foreign gig happened to be was the Experience Festival in Thailand, in Koh Tao. I was one of the main acts during that festival 2014. Next year, that was the main thing where my journey begins to expand with the Spinal Fusion project. It was my first Europe tour on 2015, and the first festival was Shankara Festival, and then it kept on going. And on 2018, I got this news that I'll be playing for Boom Festival on 2018, the year. And it was a dream come true, you know, like for a Saitama artist to, you know, play that festival. It's one of the biggest stages, and beat the crowd, beat the artists, beat the festival goers. It's one of the biggest festivals which happens by year, you know. And yeah, so it was basically a dream come true to be playing in Boom Festival.
Tell us about Profound Records and how did that start?
Yeah, so in the year 2012, yeah, so I started my label called Profound Records, and I started very slowly. It was very small, and now I've expanded to, you know, like all parts of the world. Basically, we have artists from Brazil, Israel, then from countries in Europe, from UK, and we have like good bunch of artists, good new talents, and that is my aim, you know, like where I have seen my picture from. I always take artists, you know, like honest and willing to work hard. So that is where I have thought a very different process about Profound Records. It's not that I need any, you know, like obviously, yeah, big names are very good for your label, But yes, I will. I always signed up artists who have started everything from scratch and have worked hard. And yes, and who are talented. So that's where I have taken my label forward. And yeah, right now, Profound Records have almost about more than 100, 150 releases, like in the digital platform and also in physical CDs also we have done it. So yeah, from 2012 to the year 2020, yeah, I've seen this label growing also.
What advice would you give to a young aspiring artist?
So I would like to say, like, for the aspiring artists and the new talents who are coming into the scene, who wants to start, not really with, it's just not about side dance music, it can be electronic dance music as well. So I would like to say that please don't rush on anything, you know, like, please start from the basics. If you start rushing in on anything, you will lag something behind if you start rushing on any sort of work. So it is better to go step-wise. I would say just start with some basic setup, not to buy any big equipment, because that's not going to help if you don't learn the basics. So I would rather have something small and start slowly and start get into some good classes or some good audio engineering schools where you learn the basics and then you come in and start producing. So I would say don't rush and just try and learn the basics first. I am sure you're going to go ahead and later on you're going to be successful in that.
As an artist, I'm sure you traveled a lot. So I want to know, where all have you traveled?
I've traveled all parts of the world, basically, just leaving the United States, America, as well as South America, but not the north part of it, and United Kingdom. The rest I've traveled everywhere, playing all the festivals.
Before any gig or event, do you prepare your sets?
If I'm playing a festival in Europe, I always wear before my sets, you know, like I will prepare. I want to see, like, you know, because it's a very different dance floor, you know, like when you're playing your music. If you're playing in Germany, there'll be different crowd. If you're playing somewhere in Austria or somewhere in Switzerland, there's going to be changing crowds, you know. So I cannot just go and just lay there the whole and the same sets and the same number of tracks, because there are people also who's going to travel from one festival to the other. So yes, I prepare myself, but I know what I'm going to play for the dance floor. But it's totally different. For instance, if I'm playing in Brazil, that's going to be a totally different set altogether. So yes, there are preparations before if I'm going for any set. I just don't want to go go to the DJ booth and just start playing my music random. Took some time, you know, like 5, 6 years, 7 years, and now I know what's going to happen, you know, like at this time of the day or this time of the night. Basically, like, what sort of track will work in the dance floor and what sort of track won't work in the dance floor. There are time to connect, you know, basically. That's how I do it.
Did you ever come across an experience where you were playing at a gig and someone came and asked you for a request?
Yes, I have faced it. I faced it in a club. It was a club party, basically. So they were asking to play me Bollywood songs, and I said, I have no Bollywood songs at the moment. It's a psytrance party, and the person is coming to you and asking for a Bollywood track. So I said, I'm very sorry, but if you don't like the music, you can leave. That's all I can say.
As an artist, has there been any moment in your life where you thought, you know, something technically went wrong and you're like, oh my God, I goofed up? Did that ever happen to you?
Yeah, I just tell you. So basically, it was during a live set, basically. But I was from the sound engineering recording background, you know, like I was ready with the backup also. So basically, what happens during a stage, like when I'm playing, you know, when I was playing, my sound card actually jumped and there was no audio. So, but that moment happened during a break of a track. So it was, basically the sound was jarring, and at that moment, if your audio device jumps too much, you know, like there's an interruption and there's some disconnection between the audio device and your laptop, basically. So yeah, it happened. But luckily, my CD was also on the DJ deck. So I was very quick and spontaneous enough, you know, to not the crowd know, and I changed it all of a sudden, you know. So just happened and it went all good.
One last question, Bilas. Where can people go and download music from Spinal Fusion?
They can firstly go to my SoundCloud. That is, you can just type in Spinal Fusion in SoundCloud and you'll be able to listen to my latest tracks and sets out there, and also in Spotify, Beatport, YouTube and iTunes.
Thank you, Bilas, for joining in on Let's Get Lost in the Rabbit Holes on Niche Radio. And thank you so much for sharing all your wisdom and your journey of life with our listeners.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Nisha, to get me Niche Radio. It's a very good initiative and I would like to thank everyone involved in your team. And yes, I'm very much looking forward to more journey in the rabbit hole with the Niche Radio.
Yes, and we wish you all the very best. You're a true warrior and so inspiring. Thank you so much, Bilas.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
And yes, thank you to all our listeners. Do keep tuning in at 10 a.m. every Sunday with me on Let's Get Lost in the Rabbit Hole. And coming up next is a track from Spinal Fusion. Enjoy.